Hey guys, how's it going? It is Peter Day here. I'm coming at you from I-95 South in Florida. I have another client meeting today. So the other week, I think it was last Wednesday, I was visiting a client in Florida. I'm visiting a different one in Florida this week. And what I want to do is I want to get this video out to you guys because a lot of you guys have been commenting on just how valuable the videos have been. And the topic of this video is going to be, there's been a lot of text messages going off on my phone there. The topic of this video is going to be how to build a more sustainable business, because I think that a lot of affiliate marketers are making the mistake of being reliant, very, very reliant on like one or two campaigns. And I understand sometimes it hasn't been the easiest thing for, sorry, the text messages have been going kind of bonkers there. It hasn't been the easiest thing sometimes for affiliates to find good campaigns, but so I do understand that sometimes it is, for some people, it's a little bit easier said than done, right? Like if I just tell you, you need more winning campaigns, that's probably the truth, right, of what you need in the business. But what is it going to take to actually find more winning campaigns? So this all goes back to the strategy that we've been teaching all along, which is to feed the stallions and kind of cut the bad stuff. So what I mean by feed the stallions is when you have a winning campaign, you're gonna have to figure out, at least you're gonna want to really figure out how to do extremely well on it. You got to realize my brother and I, our entire like catapulting into success, it really just came from like one initial ad campaign, and that campaign started earning us like a couple hundred bucks a day in profit, and we kept ramping it up until it was earning us over like $40,000 a month in profit, and then eventually over $100,000 a month in profit. And then the long story short is that campaign ended up pretty much dying later, but it was okay because what we did do correctly was we really ramped it very hard, right? So that was our entire success kind of catapulted from just finding a winning campaign and just hitting it super hard. And then that gave us a good kind of a bank balance to test more campaigns. Because here's the thing, if you don't have at least one strong winning campaign, it might be hard for you to justify spending all this money testing other campaigns, right? Like right now, my brother and I don't really have a problem with testing like 7 new campaigns right now, or 14 or 20 new campaigns right now, all on a small scale, because we have enough winning campaigns that have been making up for the testing loss. Because you gotta realize that whenever you're testing affiliate campaigns, I mean, you might kind of get chance here and there and get a winning campaign just immediately, but a lot of times when you're testing, you might have a loss, and then you're gonna have to figure out how to optimize your landing page and your ads and the different components to turn the campaign into a profit. So basically, this all boils down to the feed the stallions strategy though, because when you do find a winning campaign, you're gonna really want to figure out how to get like the absolute most profits out of it. Because if that campaign stops working later, you don't want any regrets, okay? What you're not gonna want is, let's say you have a good campaign, it's been earning like 500 bucks a day of profit, a couple hundred bucks a day of profit, even 1,000 or more a day of profit, right? What you don't want is,
in half a mile, keep left to stay on I-95 South.
What you don't want is for that campaign to stop working in like a month or two, and then you're back at square one, trying to find winning campaigns all over again. So you need to be more proactive rather than reactive. I think one of the biggest mistakes my brother and I made is that
keep left to stay on I-95 South.
We were very like reactive at first when we were doing our business. So when we first started doing affiliate marketing, we had a couple good campaigns, and then we didn't really launch any more campaigns until the first ones kind of stopped working. It was like this constant cycle of having some good campaigns and then essentially being forced to pretty much launch new campaigns once those stopped working. Because you got to remember that, look, the campaigns might not last forever, right? So there's a lot of things that could possibly come up. The advertiser could not want you sending any more leads due to quality. Maybe the quality's bad. Maybe the cap, maybe you are using all the cap available to you. Maybe the Facebook cost just went up. Maybe I don't know. Maybe the stock market like crashed or something, right? Like stock market's kind of been crashing today. We'll see what happens with that. But at the end of the day, the stock market really wouldn't affect. I think what the stock market could ultimately maybe affect is your buyers, right? So let's say you're doing a car insurance and like Progressive is a big buyer behind the offer, and the stock market crashes, and if coronavirus goes like viral, it is possible that maybe these buyers could not want to buy as many leads, right? Like, and it could impact. So there's just a lot of things that could come up, and but you have to be honest with yourself. Affiliate marketing is probably better than just working. It's obviously better than just working a job, right? Like if you're working a job and the stock market crashes and they can't afford to hire you anymore, then you could be out of income from your job instantaneously. And like, who wants to work the 9 to 5 for the boss anyway? But what I'm saying is that it's possible for things to come up, okay? And you want to be more proactive in building your business rather than reactive of events, unforeseen events, or whatever you want to call it, right? So even in our business, let's just look at today. The stock market is basically crashing today. What's going to come of it? I don't know, right? I'm not really an expert right now in stock stuff, but if I were to guess, it probably goes down a little bit more, and then Federal Reserve probably steps in, lowers interest rates. Maybe Trump does some stuff. Maybe the corona scare passes and the stock market goes back and continues into a new all-time high. That's possible, right? The other alternative is maybe the thing just crashes and we see like a Great Depression type of scenario, right? But regardless, if you're watching the stock market and you see it go down like 20% in like a couple days or whatever, it might make you scratch your head and say, well, how would that affect my affiliate marketing business, right? So here's the reality. My opinion is that I do believe that our business is pretty good actually to withstand a stock market crash, because first of all, an affiliate business is not directly tied to like actual equities on the stock market, right? Like you're not actually in the investing arena, so that's helpful. But another thing though that you have to keep in mind is that our business is tied to some of these bigger companies, right? So when we're promoting auto insurance, you got to remember that the buyers are like Geico and Progressive, Liberty Mutual, State Farm, and some of these big buyers. So just, well, the kind of stock market crash thingy today, even though it might just completely recover, right? You want to be proactive. So ask yourself, well, what if it didn't recover anytime soon? What could possibly happen, right? And I don't think it would be immediately, but let's just say we went into some kind of Great Depression thing. It's possible, like I said earlier, that the buyers would not want to buy as many leads. Let's say the stock market crashes 50%, and let's say, for example, the coronavirus just goes absolutely ballistic and it's in like every country and there's car sales going down everywhere. Let's just talk about like a car insurance offer, right? So, or even car financing, right? If you're running auto loan maybe the buyers don't want to buy as many leads for the dealership, right? And I'm not saying these things to scare you, but I'm saying these things so you could be smart about it, right? Because at some point, the economy probably will crash in like a huge way. At some point, something like this could happen. And it's better to be prepared for the worst, in a sense, than be caught off guard, right? So let's say you're having a ton of success promoting car loan, and you get wind that all the buyers just want to not buy as many leads. Wouldn't you rather have been prepared more ahead of time in that case? And wouldn't you rather have some life insurance campaigns going? Not to say that life insurance is not better than car loan, but I'm talking about diversity, right? Wouldn't it be better if that happened, that you have some car loan going still, life insurance, car insurance, home refi, health insurance, just Medicare. Be nice if you had some email marketing going in your business, some Facebook native search. I mean, you're just gonna wanna be diverse, because the last thing you want is for something to pull down your business when you could be prepared ahead of time. So again, it's not to scare you, it just kind of scratches the head when these things happen, and be prepared, be proactive rather than reactive. I gotta wrap up the video because the battery's about to finish up here. I'll cut another one here in a second though. We'll talk soon.